Biden administration on Friday published a sweeping set of export controls, including a measure to cut China off from certain semiconductor chips made anywhere in the world with U.S. tools, vastly expanding its reach in its bid to slow Beijing's technological and military advances. The series of measures could amount to the biggest shift in U.S. policy towards shipping technology to China since the 1990s. If effective, they could set China's chip manufacturing industry back years by forcing American and foreign companies that use U.S. technology to cut off support for some of China's leading factories and chip designers. China slammed such decision, calling it a violation of international economic and trade rules that will isolate and backfire on the U.S. Out of the need to maintain its sci-tech hegemony, the U.S. abuses export control measures to maliciously block and suppress Chinese companies, said Foreign Ministry spokeswoman Mao Ning on Saturday. It will not only damage the legitimate rights and interests of Chinese companies, but also affect American companies' interests, she said, adding that the U.S. weaponization and politicization of science and technology as well as economic and trade issues will not stop China's progress. Jim Lewis, a technology and cybersecurity expert at the Center for Strategic and International Studies, CSIS, said the U.S. measures will set the Chinese back years, noting that the policies harken back to the tough regulations of the height of the Cold War. China isn't going to give up on chipmaking, but this will really slow them down. The rules, some of which go into effect immediately, build on restrictions sent in letters earlier this year to top toolmakers KLA Corp, Lam Research Corp and Applied Materials Inc., effectively requiring them to halt shipments of equipment to wholly Chinese-owned factories producing advanced logic chips. In a briefing with reporters on Thursday previewing the rules, senior government officials said many of the measures sought to prevent foreign firms from selling advanced chips to China or supplying Chinese firms with tools to make their own advanced chips. They conceded, however, that they have not yet secured any promises that allied nations will implement similar measures and that discussions with those nations are continuing. We recognize that the unilateral controls we're putting into place will lose effectiveness over time if other countries don't join us, one official said. And we risk harming U.S. technology leadership if foreign competitors are not subject to similar controls. The expansion of U.S. powers to control exports to China of chips made with U.S. tools is based on a broadening of the so-called Foreign Direct Product Rule. It was previously expanded to give the U.S. government authority to control exports of chips made overseas to Chinese telecoms giant Huawei Technologies Company Limited and later to stop the flow of semiconductors to Russia after its invasion of Ukraine. As the Biden administration intensifies its tech decoupling push, more and more U.S. and global businesses will see increasing losses. For example, after the U.S. government prohibited U.S. semiconductor firm Nvidia from selling sophisticated chips to China at the end of August, the company estimated that it may lose approximately $400 million in potential sales to China in the third quarter and actively engaged with the U.S. government in seeking exemptions. If the new measures are strictly implemented, it could put as much as 30% of some U.S. and global chip industry giants' total revenue at risk because China's revenue accounts for one-third of their total revenue, Han Xiaomin, general manager of Jiwei Insights in Beijing, said. Global chip companies are already starting to consider ways to overcome the impact of the new U.S. export controls. SK Hynix is prepared to do its best to obtain a license from the U.S. government and will work closely with the South Korean government to this end, the company said in a statement. We are also prepared to operate our manufacturing plants in China smoothly, under the premise of abiding by international rules. The U.S. move will also cause the most harm to its own R&D. As it costs vast financial and human resources investment in the R&D of cutting-edge chips, U.S. companies will unlikely see much returns without chip exports to China and could barely reinvest in future R&D, said Gao Lingyun, an expert at the Chinese Academy of Social Sciences in Beijing. The Semiconductor Industry Association, which represents 99% of the U.S. semiconductor industry by revenue and nearly two-thirds of non-U.S. chip firms, on Friday urged the U.S. government to implement the rules in a targeted way, and in collaboration with international partners, to help level the playing field and mitigate unintended harm to U.S. innovation. The new regulations will also severely restrict the export of U.S. equipment to Chinese memory chip makers and formalize letters sent to NVIDIA Corp and Advanced Micro Devices Inc., AMD, restricting shipments to China of chips used in supercomputing systems that nations around the world rely on to develop nuclear weapons and other military technologies.